Hello fellow artists, and welcome to DRAWFUSION, the game where several artists fuse their ideas into one to create one crazy character design. Here's how the game works. Each artist will spin a wheel to randomly decide what specific aspect of a character design they'll get to choose. Once each artist has decided on what they will choose for their part of the character design, all of their ideas will be fused into one single character design prompt. They will all then use this prompt to design a character. Once all the designs are complete, they'll reveal their wacky creations. Without further ado, let's meet the artists participating in today's video.
I have a YouTube channel, it's called Niro. I mainly draw like an anime style.
I go by name Midori and I mostly focus on making mangas, but recently I started making YouTube videos as well.
Hello everyone, my name is Sweet Sailor Sketches. I make YouTube videos and yeah, that's pretty much it.
Hi, my name is Light. I'm a multi-fandom artist who likes making a lot of fan art, but I've been trying to do more original art and try and do more YouTube videos.
Now that you're familiar with the artists, let's get started on making the prompt. Who wants to go first? Who wants to do the first spin?
You guys can go first.
I'll go first, sure.
Okay, let's see what you get.
Yes!
Oh,
yes.
That's
I love
a good
weapons.
One.
This is perfect. Let's go.
Favorite hobby.
Oh, the character's favorite hobby.
Oh, nice.
Oh, the character's personality. Ooh. We'll see what you can do with that.
Nice.
Oh, okay, you get the character's power, which means I get to decide the species.
I have to pick my favorite weapon, obviously. I'm gonna go with scythes.
Because we are all artists, I want the hobby to be an artist, but it's vague. Yes, it can be any type of artist. It can be up to our interpretations.
I'm choosing the species to be a half-human, half-dragon hybrid, because I think that's a cool idea.
Revive dead chickens.
I'm just gonna go with a lively approach, like extroverted and cheerful, something like that.
Okay, everyone has chosen their prompt, so give me a minute to combine them all into one big one and then I'll share it with you guys.
1 minute later.
Okay, I have written the final prompt.
Yes.
Awesome.
I'm kind of scared.
You should be, you really should be. Okay, this is the final prompt. This character is a half-human, half-dragon hybrid who wields a scythe. They're extroverted and cheerful, and consider themselves to be an artist. They also have the mystical power to revive dead chickens.
So I actually drafted out the original concept of my character on a sticky note. I like to do a lot of little sketches traditionally or elsewhere to kind of get the feel of the character so I don't go into the final piece blind. I really want to do a warm color palette around the color red since it's the first one that comes to mind when I think about dragons. I was really on the fence whether or not to add actual features such as the wings and tail, but I think it really added to the character design. I feel like with the pose that I tried to go to was a little bit more ambitious for my taste, but I kind of didn't really want to make it super static. With that being said, I think the final piece was mostly inspired by specifically splash art from Genshin Impact, since that's my main fandom that I draw fan art for at the moment. I've been using Clip Studio Paint as my main program for a while now, so you can totally see me use Lasso Fill, which is my lifesaver when it comes to art pieces. And last but not least, we can't forget about the little chickens, but I also decided to work up on the final background, and I actually had a little bit of trouble with this. You can see me, I just tried a bunch of different color combinations on the back, but I ultimately decided with like a little moon graveyard background because the prompt for magic is being able to raise chickens from the dead, and I thought it would be hilarious to add an actual live chicken confused on what's going on with its dead brethren. And that's the summary of the process of my character, Sully.
Oh my,
this looks
my
awesome.
God, that is so good.
Alright, let's see. Oh shoot, I forgot to mention, it was kind of inspired by like splash art for like gacha games. So those are two like dead yellow chickens, and I decided to add like a little live one because it was hilarious to be, you know, a real live chicken with its dead brethren. So let's see, the name of my character, so his name is Sole, it's spelled S-O-L-I-L-E-I-L. He's a 26-year-old dragon slash human hybrid. He lives on his lonesome near the edge of the forest near trails towards volcanic mountains, and he warns and guides slash travelers away from the mountains and its intense heat. He's also an artist, but specifically does pottery. He has his own stand that he sets up at the local town's monthly markets. He creates his works using clay that he discovers and digs up within his trips to the mountains, and he also likes to farm and takes care of livestock. Using his powers, he's able to use undead chickens as like guard dogs for any intruders.
Oh my goodness, that was such a lore dump. It feels like you really thought this character through.
You gotta get that lore in with the character.
I am, like, I have an intense fear of birds, but I love those chickens. I want to hug that chicken, and that says a lot because I'm scared of birds.
Giant, the chickens must have been terrifying.
I just decided not to look up references and just wing it because I just can't look at a bird for that long.
Is
they
that
genuinely
a pun?
Horrify me.
Wing it.
But I'm glad that you like my chickens.
Not intentionally, but sure.
The design's pretty cool, but the lore is pretty interesting as well because mine was just there, so I didn't add more depth to like that part.
I just like making up lore.
Yeah, I think you went above and beyond with it, with the lore.
Okay, so this is Eustace. He was raised in a dragon clan that was prominently known for violence, both in survival and sport. Eustace did not seem to have any powers, so he was not valued in the clan and was often forced into fights. And over the years, he was able to become like strong enough to beat a well-known and loved dragon that had been bullying him for a long time. And because of that, a gang of dragons like beat him up and kicked him out of the clan, resulting in the loss of his wings, a scar on his along his face, and his only horn being snapped in half. The only thing that they allowed him to take with him when they kicked him out was some of his painting supplies and a scythe. One day when he was walking on a path, he found a family of chickens dead on the side of the road, and he is a very sympathetic, like, he loves animals, vegan, that kind of thing, and he like bent over them and one of his scales fell off onto an open wound from one of the chickens, and it came back to life, but not just as a chicken, as a half chicken, half dragon.
Oh my goodness!
Oh, there's another drawing, but that was the smaller file.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness!
Oh my gosh!
This second illustration? Incredible.
I just couldn't stop myself. I had to draw him again. Okay.
Even added an entire background.
I love those chickens. Those are the best.
Thank you.
Is that a concerned expression on a chicken?
Yeah.
He's
trying to paint the chicken in front of him. But it doesn't really look like the chicken because he considers himself an artist, but he's really not that good. And the chicken on his shoulder is just like, what is that? So
I actually love the concept of what you did with the chickens, like turning them into half dragons, like the character. That's actually awesome.
Oh, thank you.
Again, amazing like character building. And I also like the face on the chicken. Really impressive.
Thank you.
So, I have an OC, Kikuchi Ryoto, who is like a humanoid dragon, so I've used similar features on this design, only made his neck a bit shorter. I also used Japanese dragon designs as a reference. For the artist part, I've made him hold a hichiriki, which is a Japanese instrument, making him a musician. His horns were supposed to be very long, and I was even thinking maybe adding sakuras on them, but in the end I liked the tiny ones better, so I erased the rest. For the hair, I got inspiration from Neji from Naruto, as well as adding some glass ball things I saw somewhere. I don't know where though, but I like them. And for the attire, I've made up something inspired by Japanese yukatas, but short, and gave him a little bracelet. To show that the chickens were dead, I drew each of them heavily injured or with bones sticking out, or as just bones. I've decided to shade this piece with hatching and cross hatching. And for colors, I really wanted him to look like a koi fish. I also made his attire resemble water, and every chicken got a different color as well. And for his name, I came up with it mid-design, but then forgot, so I had to furiously look on the internet, but luckily found it again. So here we have Sasaki Mamoru.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god.
That looks insane.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I love the colors.
Thank you.
First of all, I absolutely love like the dragon design, like having it like have these orange and black and white patterns looks incredible. And also like the half undead chickens you've drawn, oh my, they just look incredible.
I love the one that's just a skeleton. It's just perfect.
I just had to draw a skeleton chicken. No stopping
my
me.
Demons, but I love it.
Yeah, also the skin is unique, like the colors. It's really cool.
Thank you.
Alright, so this is my character Nirses. She's a dragon and human hybrid that can resurrect some dead chickens. She also has a sight, but more on that later. First up is the dragon design. I don't really draw much dragon characters, let alone actual dragons, so I was really overwhelmed by the choices that I can make. The horns alone had so much variations in design, but I just kept it simple. The wings and tail were also kind of basic. Next up is reviving the chickens part. Immediately, my first thought was to put a headless chicken, but I realized it's already been done, so I added a detached head. Also, when I was drawing the chicken head, I forgot what chickens look like, so it came out like that. The trickiest part was including the artist part, the design, because from dragon, sight, and reviving the dead chickens part, I was already going for a darker approach, like a warrior in the battlefield or something. But I decided to go for a lighter design to incorporate the artist part. And the last one is of course the sight. I wasn't really sure how I would show the artist part because the 8-print wasn't really doing much. But I got the idea when I saw a shadow sight, so I thought, what if I made the sight out of paint? But I didn't really like the bright colors, so I decided to go with the ink look. And that's it for my design.
Oh my goodness, this is absolutely incredible. From such a weird like prompt that we all got, you actually made this look like a solid character design. And also the ink scythe idea, like that's why they're an artist. That's such a good incorporation of like combining two parts of the prompt into one. So yeah, very awesome.
Thank you.
Your art style is so clean. I'm just like staring at it. It's great.
I love the way that the ink looks. I just can't stop looking at it.
Yeah, I just use like random brushes to make that effect.
Detail's amazing. I love it.
Thank you.
Okay, so this was a really interesting prompt. I'll just quickly go over how I tried to include everything in the prompt in the design. But first of all, for the half-human, half-dragon bit, I decided to give this character a dragon's tail. I made their legs turn into like kind of dragon legs, and same with their arms, and I also gave them horns. And the rest of her is completely human, so that's kind of the half-dragon, half-human bit. For making her extroverted and cheerful, I tried to do that with her pose and facial expression. I gave her a very like kind of happy, positive kind of facial expression and drew her in this kind of excited jumping pose. So I think that kind of got that across. And here's the interesting part. For the last three aspects of this prompt, we had to make this character an artist, give them a scythe, and give them the ability to revive dead chickens. I tried to combine all of these aspects. So I decided to make her a music artist, so a musician, who uses her scythe, which is also a guitar, to play songs that have the power to revive dead chickens. That's all of my design. Let's see how it turned out.
The way dropped to the floor, that is... I love the scythe guitar. That is amazing.
Thank you, that's my favorite
my
part.
Reaction exactly.
That's really creative, yes. I never would have thought that.
I love the chicken in the front.
The screaming one?
Yeah.
I really like how you incorporated, like you combined all the prompts together for one giant thing. Like the scythe, the music ability, and the magic. It's really big-brained.
I'm really happy with how that turned out as well.
Yeah, I just love the floating grass block. I think it's beautiful.
I didn't want to commit to a full background, so I just put the floating grass block with the graveyards there. I think we all did some freaking incredible designs from this weird prompt that we all made. I did not think this would turn out this well. Like, all of these designs are absolutely incredible. I love all of them. And they're all really unique as well. Like, I think we each chose, like, different... We all had to choose what kind of artists they were. I think all of us kind of did a different take on that, essentially. And also the way we presented them as dragon, like half dragons. Everyone had a kind of a unique idea for that.
Like, the reviving the chickens part was really tricky. I thought it was pretty random, but yeah.
And we all had such unique ideas for the chickens as well. Like, everyone's is different.
Yeah.
This is just really so fun.
Yeah, so much fun.
I showed it to my mom, and she laughed so hard about the dead chickens turning into dragons. I don't know why she found it so funny.
Who knew such awesome character designs could be made from that crazy prompt? Well, do you guys have a favorite? If so, let me know in the comments down below. And make sure to check out all the artists that participated in this video. And make sure to leave links to all of their channels in the description. And yeah, that's the end of the video. Bye!